Hey everybody, this is Michelle Goldstein, and this is the forgiveness practice in the Heart Alchemy Yoga series. So the practice of forgiveness is really a powerful means in bringing us truly into the present moment, into letting go of past resentments, fears, angers, frustrations, and really truly allowing life to flow freely, to allow love to move freely through us. So we're going to start out in child's pose today. Separate your knees a little wider than your hips and walk your hands forwards. And so, yeah, truly the heart alchemy practice is the practice of transforming everything into love. And the more quickly we can forgive, the more readily it flows. So begin to deepen your breath in and out through your nose. And so when I say quickly, I am also aware of the fact that this can be a process, forgiveness. It doesn't always happen instantaneously. But with the practice of breathing and the deep movement into these postures, that can really help assist in dislodging any kind of negative held feelings and really truly bring us to a space where we're experiencing love. Because love is not just an internal thing. It's something that we express with everything everywhere when it's really truly flowing. It's not just for one person and nobody else. It's for everybody everywhere. And so as you begin to breathe here, see if you can breathe for really, truly the whole of humanity. As if you could teach everyone everywhere to breathe deeply with your steady flowing breath. And come up to all fours, hands and knees, and tuck your toes and lift your hips. And press yourselves back to downward facing dog pose. Inhale up on your toes. And exhale, press your right heel down to the ground. And inhale, lift your right heel up. And exhale, left heel sinks down to the ground. Good, again, inhale, lift the left heel. And exhale, the right heel sinks down. Good. Inhale, heels lift. And exhale, the left heel sinks. Beautiful. Inhale, both heels lift up. And exhale, both heels press down to the ground. And as you press the inner hand down, as you press the fingers down into the ground, start to lift the shoulder blades up the back. Slope the hips up towards the ceiling. And as you get that lift from the fingertips to the hips, press your thigh bones back into their sockets. Shift forwards to plank position, upper push-up as you inhale. As you exhale, press back to downward facing dog pose. Inhale to plank position. Lengthen the heart forwards, heels back. Exhale back to downward dog. Good. Now one more time. Inhale to plank. And exhale back to downward facing dog. Good. Inhale, float your right leg up to the sky. Open the right hip, bend the right knee. See if you can drop the right shoulder a little bit so that the upper back stays level and stable. Square off your hips. Square off your hips. Extend the right leg straight back behind you. Step your right foot all the way up to the front of your mat. And go ahead and bring your right hand to the inside of the right foot, heel toe, the right foot over to the right. Good. And you can be on your hands or on your fingertips, your choice. See if you can get the hips and the right knee about the same level. So the right knee's at a 90 degree angle. And the inner thighs squeeze in towards each other. And get a little extension in the upper back. So almost a little cobra in the upper back. If it helps you to come onto the fingertips to get that, do that. One more breath. Good. And press back to downward dog pose. Beautiful. Inhale to plank position, upper push-up. Exhale, lower chaturanga or the floor. Good. Flip over the toes. Inhale, up dog or cobra for your first vinyasa here. Good. Exhale back to downward facing dog. Deep breath. So the first couple of down dogs oftentimes are a little bit like, ugh, this is challenging. And then as we start to warm up a little bit, they get a little easier. So be gentle with yourself as you move into your body. There's no goal aside from just being here present in this moment. Lift your left leg up as you inhale. And as you ride the breath, open the left hip, bend the left knee. Maintain a little cat tilt in the pelvis so that you're not dumping into the lower back. So lengthen the tailbone towards your left heel. Then square off your hips. Feel the difference. And step your left foot all the way up to the front of your space. And both hands to the inside of the left foot. Maybe heel toe the left foot to the left an inch. And get your left knee at a 90 degree angle. And deep breath, the inner thigh squeeze. And the right thigh just gently lifts up into its socket as you extend through the upper back. And keep the back of your neck long and the belly firm for support. Good. Step back to downward dog pose. And again, inhale to plank position. And exhale, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. And exhale back to downward dog pose. Deep breath. So especially in a forgiveness practice today, be so extra gentle with yourself. Allow yourself to really, truly take care of your body's needs. Inhale, lift your heels up. Exhale, walk your feet up to the front of your mat. Good. Inhale, elongate your spine. And exhale, fold into your legs. And take a moment to align your feet, either feet together or hips apart and parallel. And inhale all the way up to stand with a flat back. Rise up. And exhale, the palms connect at the heart. Just close your eyes for a moment and become aware of anybody or anything that you may be holding negative feelings towards. And perhaps you dedicate your practice to them today. Inhale, the arms sweep out and up. And exhale, fold forwards. Inhale, lengthen your spine. And exhale, step back to plank position. From your plank, shift forwards on your toes. Lower down, chaturanga or the floor. Good. Inhale, up dog or cobra pose. And exhale, back to downward facing dog. Deep conscious breath. In fact, when we become conscious of the breath, it often deepens anyway. And this is the power of our awareness. When we become conscious of what we're doing, we deepen the experience. And to be conscious of where we're holding on, especially to negative feelings that we no longer need, then we can let them go. Inhale, lift your heels up. Exhale, bring your feet to your hands, walk or hop. Inhale, lengthen out. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise to stand, reach the arms up. Good. Exhale, the palms connect at the heart. Inhale, the arms reach up. Exhale, fold forwards. Inhale, lengthen out. Exhale, step back or jump back to chaturanga with bent elbows. Inhale, upward facing dog. And exhale back to downward dog pose. And do feel especially your thumb and pointer fingers press into the ground. And feel the triceps, the upper arms, the upper outer arms hug into the biceps, the upper inner arms. And then again, lengthen through the side ribs, the side waist. And activate your legs. So the quads engage to release the backs of the legs. Inhale, heels lift, hips lift. Exhale, walk or hop your feet up. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, bow. Inhale, rise to stand, reach up. And exhale, the palms meet at the heart. Good, one more time. Inhale, reach the arms. Exhale, fold forwards. Good, inhale, lengthen out. And exhale, flow, step, or jump back. Good. Over the toes, inhale, upward dog. And exhale, back, downward dog pose. Go ahead and step your right foot up to your hands. Be on your back toes. Come up to crescent pose, please. Good, deep breath, sit the hips down a little bit. Lift the frontal hip points up a little bit. Good, soften the shoulders away from the ears. And maybe relax your face as well. And feel the right thigh sink down into its socket. That's it. One more breath in. And as you exhale, take the hands down to the mat and come to standing split. Lift the left leg up, straighten your legs. If it's helpful, you can take your hands to a block or to two blocks. Work the inner right foot down, the especially big toe mound and inner heel on the right foot, and then lift the inner arch to wake up your feet. And then as you breathe here, savor the experience. Like even if it's challenging, it still feels hopefully kind of nice. And if it doesn't feel kind of nice, then back it off or adjust it so that it does. And get your shoulders away from your ears. And just one more breath here. Good. Now step your left foot straight back behind you. And step back to down dog split. So lift the right leg straight back and up, inhale. And as you exhale, bring your right knee into your chest, shift forwards to plank, and hug your right knee into your chest for a few moments here. So press the inner hand down, hug the right knee in, good. And then plank pose, both legs straight, lengthen your spine, and lower yourself down, chaturanga. Good, inhale, upward dog. Exhale, back, downward dog pose. Good. Step your left foot up to your hands, please, and come up to crescent pose. So for this forgiveness practice today, we're invoking the spirit of forgiveness, as well as moving deeply into the hips, where we tend to hold lots of emotion. And oftentimes when we're letting go of the things that come up for us, of the things that we've held on to, oftentimes we're holding on to other people, places, things that we feel like we need to hold accountable, including ourselves, actually. But to actually let go of all of that stuff, it's all history. And just be here now, present, fully engaged. Like, how can you facilitate that in your own experience? Hug the inner thighs together. And for me, I find that the breath work is for sure the way to go when it comes to that. Like, every deep conscious breath is a moment away from the thinking mind. Feel the left thigh sink down a little bit. Good. And one more inhale, heart lifting. And exhale the hands down, standing split. Lift the right leg up. Work the inner left foot down. So learn to use your foot points. It's very important, actually, because the way we use our feet determines the way that we use the rest of our bodies when we're at least on them. I mean, if even in a handstand, though, I would say the way that you're using your feet is definitely changing the way that you're using the rest of your body. So to activate the foot mounds down and lift the arches up will help to activate the inner leg muscles and change the way that you use, as I say, the rest of your body. Now take your shoulders away from your ears. And maybe you start to melt a little bit into the pose. One more breath. Good, you guys. Step your right foot straight back behind you. Step to down dog split. So the left leg lifts up as you inhale, get some length. And exhale, hug the left knee into your chest, round in. Good. And relax your face a little bit. And just make it count. It's the only time we'll probably do this today. One more breath. Good. Plank. Inhale. And chaturanga. Exhale. Beautiful. Inhale, upward facing. And exhale back to downward facing dog pose. And everybody take a deep clearing breath in. Fill up, up, up. And exhale out the mouth. Inhale, heels lift. Exhale, bring your feet to your hands. Good. Inhale, lengthen out. Exhale, forward fold. Good. Bend your knees. Come to chair pose as you inhale. Sweep the arms up. And exhale, fold forwards. The legs straighten. Good. Inhale, flat back. Heart lengthens forwards. Exhale, vinyasa step or jump back. Move through your flow, and when you get to downward facing dog pose, step your right foot up to your hands, spin your back heel flat to the floor, come up warrior one pose for a breath, bend the right knee, sweep the arms up, and exhale, release the hands down to your mat, step back to plank position, and lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Good. Exhale back, downward dog pose. The left foot steps through. Back heel roots down. Warrior one pose. Lift the low belly up as you sit down into it. And exhale, release the hands. Step back and lower. Good. Inhale, upward facing. Exhale back, downward dog pose. Breathing deeply. Feel the rib cage fill and soften with your breath. Inhale, heels lift. Exhale, float your feet up. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold in. Good. Bend your knees. Chair pose. Inhale. Sweep the arms. Lift the frontal hip points. Good. Exhale. Fold forwards. The legs straight. Good. Inhale. Flat back. Exhale. Vinyasa. Make your way back through your flow. And the same sequence here. So when you get to downward dog, step your right foot up, spin your back heel flat, warrior one pose, one breath, and let it go. So move at your own pace here, for sure. Always step your left foot through. Especially on your mat, we're going for the inner rhythm. And we're looking to follow the inner rhythm of our bodies in relationship to the rhythm of life. So it's really, a harmonizing of ourselves with everything else. And so if you lock your elbows, make sure you unlock the elbows. And again, firm up the upper arms. Inhale, heels lift, hips lift. Exhale, walk or hop your feet up. Okay, so one more round here. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold in. Bend your knees, sit deeply. Inhale to chair pose. And exhale, fold forwards. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, step or jump back. Inhale, up dog. Down dog. Exhale, step your right foot through, back heel flat. Warrior one pose, inhale. Good, and release. Move through your flow. Good, and switch sides. Beautiful. When you get to downward dog pose, lift your right leg up, inhale. And just for a breath, step the right foot through to lunge. Come up warrior one pose, big inhale. Open up to warrior two on your exhale. Good. Reverse warrior for a breath, inhale. And exhale the hands down to your mat. Step back to plank. And lower. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Left leg lifts, inhale. Exhale, left foot steps through. Warrior one pose, inhale. Good. Warrior two, exhale. Reverse warrior, inhale. Good. Exhale, the hands down. Step back. Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing, lift the thighs and up dog. Good. Exhale, back, downward facing dog pose. Good. Deepest breath in and out. And step your right foot up to your hands again. Spin the back heel flat. Stay low for a minute. Just heel toe your right foot over to the right. And hug the right hip into the midline of your body. So hug the right hip into the left. Good. Now come up to warrior one pose. Good. Wrap your left arm under your right arm for eagle wrap. Left arm under the right. Good. And sit down into the right hip a little bit. And step your left leg up and over the right leg for eagle pose. I do teach this pose a lot. I'm a proponent of it. I think it's a great stretch for the outer hips and the inner legs. It's also awesome for the upper back. It hits a spot between the shoulder blades that it's like nothing else can, it seems. So play with that. So soften the shoulder blades down, soften the hips down into the pose, the sitting bones down. But maybe you kind of give it a little lift of the pelvic floor, lift of the frontal hip points, lift the elbows maybe a little bit. And just for a moment, consider the look on your face. And if your face were to be frozen like this for the rest of your life, is that okay with you? And so then adjust it so that it's the way you want it to be, right? And sit down one more inch. And keep the arms like this, but softly, softly step your left leg straight back to that warrior one pose. Good. And from here, keep the elbows wrapped. Inhale, lift them up. And exhale, fold forwards. And inhale, float back up. Keep the elbows wrapped. And exhale, fold in. Nice. And with the breath, inhale one more time. Sweep the arms up. Now exhale, fold in. Beautiful. Now come up, warrior one. Release the arms. Interlace your fingers behind your back. I know this is a ton of hip work, but you're doing amazing. Lift your heart up and then bow in to humble warrior pose. So we're intentionally moving deeply into the hips. If you feel like it would help you to take a wider stance, then maybe heel toe that right foot over to the right an inch. And start to point your tailbone towards your left heel. So the right hip really hugs in quite a bit to center. And the head drops and the neck soft and the breath deep as you sit into the experience. Good. And then use your belly, come up warrior one more time. Inhale. Good. Exhale, release the hands down. Step to plank position and lower down, chaturanga. Up dog, inhale. You can skip these vinyasas, by the way. Exhale back, downward dog. Nice. Step your left foot up to your hands. Come up, warrior one. Good. Wrap the right arm under the left arm. Align the hip. So draw the left thigh bone back into a socket. Good. And step your right leg up and over your left leg for eagle pose. Watch your breath. Watch your breath. Sit your sitting bones down a little bit. Sit your sitting bones down. Sit the shoulder blades down the back. But lift the pelvic floor. Lift the frontal hip points. Lift the elbows. Lift the corners of your mouth. Maybe a little bit. If you're not feeling it, it's not a good idea. But if you're feeling like you could, it may change the experience. Keep the arms wrapped. Step the right leg straight back to warrior one legs. And stay here. Inhale, heart lifting. And exhale, fold in. Good. With the breath, inhale, come up. And as you exhale, fold in. Good. One more time. Inhale, sweep up. Exhale, fold in. Good. Inhale, come up. Hug that left hip into center. Release the arms. And interlace your fingers with the opposite grip behind your back, shoulder blades together. And fold forwards. Fold forwards. So I'll just put this in here. I think this is really important to remember. If it starts to feel like too much, always back it off. You could move in deeper. You could sit with it when it's too much, but too much is too much, and too much is over the edge. Too little, same thing. If you're not really getting much, then maybe you go in a little deeper. Be honest with yourself, because only you really know. Only you really know. We're going for just the right mixture of effort and ease. So forgive yourself for being human. It's not going to look the way that somebody on a screen is looking. It's not going to look the way anybody else makes it look. And it's certainly not going to look the way you did it yesterday or the way that you know, maybe would possibly want it tomorrow. It is the way it is right now. So with pure acceptance and breath, come up warrior one pose. Big breath in. Good. Release your hands down to your mat. Step back. Lower chaturanga. Up dog, inhale. Good. Exhale back, downward dog pose. Good. Deepest breath in through the nose, like the deepest breath you've ever taken in your whole life. Inhale, fill up, and sigh it out. Good. Step your right foot up to your hands, please. Come up, warrior one pose. And open up to warrior two. press your right leg straight and lengthen forwards into triangle pose. Make sure that your back foot turns in, heel out a little bit. That's it. And start to take your right sitting bone and point it to your left heel. So you bring that right leg into an external rotation. You're welcome to take your right hand to a block if that helps you. And soften the lower ribs into the back ribs. Hug in more. Yes, that's it, like that. Good. Deeply breathing. Press the inner edge of the right foot down. And lengthen from your right hip crease to your right shoulder. So you shorten the left side of your torso to lengthen the right side. So contract here a little bit. That's it. Okay, when you're ready, step up to half moon pose, Ardha Chandrasana. Grab the block if it helps you. Seriously, like this is such a great practice, the forgiveness practice with the practice of modifying and taking deep care. To just completely wipe the slate clean of any negative thoughts that you have about yourself, that's so powerful. You're amazing. Seriously, to remember that. Externally rotate the right hip, that's it, the right thigh. Check in with the breath. And so from here, check it out. The transition from here is going to be all the way up to tree pose. So slow, slow, come up, lift the left knee, slow, engage your belly. Yep. Take your left foot to your right thigh. Bring your palms together in front of your heart. Maybe you extend the arms up. If you take the arms up, slide the shoulders down the back. Actually, if you don't have the arms up, slide the shoulders down the back as well. I can't even think of one exception to that rule. Like whenever you remember, take the shoulders away from the ears and get space around your neck. Good. Set your left foot down next to your right. Palms meet in front of the heart. Forgive yourself for falling. Forgive yourself for wobbling. Forgive yourself for gloating because you're such a badass and you did it so perfectly. Just be present. Reach your arms up. Inhale. Exhale, fold forwards. Any labels, any judgments, those are not the truth. Inhale, lengthen out. They're just labels and judgments. Exhale, step or jump back. The truth is always, always coming from a place of love. Even if it's a loving, seemingly loving label or judgment, that label or judgment is creating separation between it and everything else. And so when we're just in a space of love and truth, it just is. So we're here to experience the full isness of being. Step your left foot up to your hands, please. Come up, warrior one. And you're doing amazing. Open up to warrior two. That's it. Press your left leg straight. Take a moment to align your feet. If you need to take a shorter stance, that's fine. Turn your back foot in. Legs straight, lengthen forwards into triangle pose. There you go. If you lock your knees, I suggest you unlock them and engage the quadriceps. So the thighs lift, which, to be honest, it took me about 2.5 years to learn how to do that, just that alone. So be gentle with yourself if you don't get all of these cues that we're teaching, you know, in yoga classes. You're learning, and it's the experience of learning. So you could try and try and try. The idea is that you just keep getting up and going for it. The practice is not intended to damage your ego. It's not intended to stroke your ego. If anything, this is an opportunity to transcend the ego completely. And when we're breathing deeply, we've transcended. When we're just breathing deeply. Step up to half moon pose when you're ready, please. Flex the right foot. And again, take that left sitting bone and point it towards the right heel. So that left leg comes to an external rotation. That's it, I know. It's intense, right? Work the inner left foot down and soften the lower ribs into the back ribs. And again, like put a little kindness in your eyes, soften your face a little bit. Super slow motion, come up to tree pose. Good, breathe. Be gentle with yourself. Because honestly, your ability to transition from half moon pose to tree pose in a yoga practice is a relatively useless skill, actually, in life. Like if life gets challenging or you're stressed out, your ability to do that, it may help you for a moment to release tension, but you may not have the luxury of being able to practice. The ability to immerse in gentleness, kindness, forgiveness, and breath is invaluable. You can apply these skills anywhere. So to apply the bigger picture understanding and the highest self engaged is really, this is the life-changing stuff. The yoga asana are useful tools for exploring these principles, but they're not the practice. Tree pose is not the practice. Your breath and your experience is the practice. Set your right foot down next to your left. The palms meet in front of the heart center. Good. Get yourself grounded. Inhale the arms, reach up. Good. Exhale, fold in half. Inhale, elongate, take the shoulders back. And exhale, just step back to plank position, upper push-up. Good. Shift forwards on your toes and lower yourself all the way down to the ground. Good. Release your toes. Bend your knees. Catch your feet with your hands. Bring your knees together to start. They may splay out a little bit, but just be mindful that the knees don't come any wider than the hips. And come up to bow pose. Allow the back of your neck to be long so that you keep the energy of the spine easily flowing up and down the back. And for the last couple of moments, see if you can allow the energy of the pose to lift you up into it. One more breath. Good. Release. Rest. Rest. Bend your knees, please. Catch your feet with your hands. Good. Come on up to bow. Come on up. And keep a little space between your chin and your chest without cranking the neck up or collapsing it. Right? So it's that main line of energy. This is most of the yoga poses are really intended to create space around the spine, integrity in our being able to stand upright, especially back bends. One more breath, lift up, exhale, release down. And press back to child's pose, everybody. Press back to child's pose and allow your torso to drape over your legs. Come up to all fours, hands and knees. And bring your right leg through for pigeon pose, everybody. If it's helpful for you to take a block and slide it under your right hip, then do that. Go ahead and do that, or a blanket. If you have knee issues, maybe you take thread the eye of the needle on your back instead. Go ahead and walk yourselves forwards. Guide your breath, direct your breath into the places that you feel the stretch. If you ever feel like you're hanging on by a thread, like if you were to really completely relax, you'd just burst out into tears, I suggest you just burst out into tears. Let it go. When you're on your mat, especially, this is a safe place. This is a container to hold your letting go. And oftentimes in a practice like a forgiveness practice, There's so many feelings that come up. However they come out of your body, get them out. Better out than in. Better out than in. In fact, I was in this pose a few days ago, and it was like this massive release. It was a trip. I've been in pigeon pose almost every day for 15 years and never had a release that deep before. So there's tension and past patterning, habits, thoughts, fears, what have you, that get trapped in the body. And when we let them go, we experience freedom and ease. And where there's freedom, there's love flowing freely. Press yourselves up, walk yourselves up. And from here, you're just going to swing your left leg around to the front of your mat and take your left ankle over your right knee. So we're setting up for double pigeon here, actually. Left ankle over the right knee. Right ankle under the left knee. Flex your feet. Flex your feet. Some of you, we've got a bunch of very flexible people here, but some of you, your top knee will be lifted way up. In which case you can just rest your elbow on your top knee. Actually, either way you can, but just know that it's correct if your knees are stacked on top of the ankles or if the knees lifted up. Walk yourselves forwards, please. You can rest your forehead on a block here. If your left knee is way up high, you can just maybe put a little bit of gentle pressure with the left elbow and just allow it to release. And again, like your whole life, you could practice this pose every day and never get your knees and ankles to stack perfectly. And it's fine, right? It's perfect already the way that it is. So we're not here to change anything. It's already perfect. We're here to accept how it is and work with it. The goal is this moment right now. Walk yourselves up and swing your right leg around behind you. Come to pigeon on the left side. And walk yourself in as you're ready. And allow it to be accessible. So if your body doesn't fit in a pose like it does in all of these other yoga teachers that are here practicing, you know, just be so loving and gentle with yourself. I mean, my first probably 5 years of yoga, I spent really actually hating on myself quite a bit in my practice. I mean, I was learning to love myself, but I would get frustrated that I couldn't go as deep as the person next to me, or I wasn't as strong as somebody I saw in a magazine or something. And honestly, that time, you know, it could have been better spent. However, I've learned from that experience. But now knowing better, now knowing that, okay, it's cool the way that it is, to move into that space of deep care for yourself, of deep forgiveness for whatever's happened. It's done. It's history. Forgiveness is the practice of letting go of the past. And so you can go back a million times in your head and you're never going to change it. It is what it is. And so just to get to a place where we're at peace, where we've let that all go, then we can really truly work with what we've got. And when we're breathing consciously, we are present. The breath is always happening. It's dynamic like that. You can't take the breath that you just took 5 minutes ago, and you've not yet reached the one that you'll take 5 minutes from now, presuming that that's coming. But this one that's moving through you right now, it's so precious. Be mindful of how it feels. Savor it like you're savoring a fine wine or a juicy fruit. Press yourselves up, walk yourselves up. Swing your right leg around to the front of your mat. Stack your right ankle on top of your left knee and your left ankle on top of your right knee. And flex your feet a lot. And maybe you walk yourselves forwards. If you can't walk forwards, again, it's fine, right? It's always fine. And you know, the days that I feel especially stiff and kind of creaky, those are the days that I think I get the most benefit from my practice. The days that I'm not really in the mood, but I practice anyway. So you can appreciate what you're working with, even if you don't really particularly love it, if it's not your favorite. See if you can slow down your breath a little bit. So eventually you get to like a 30 second inhale and a 30 second exhale. Go ahead and walk yourselves up. And come to sit with the soles of your feet together and the knees drop open. Lengthen your spine forwards for Baddha Konasana. You can bring the heels in closer if you want more of a stretch in the inner legs, or the legs, the heels a little further away if you want more of a stretch in the outer hip. Let's see if you can gather a little extension through your spine. Even if it means that you're sitting more upright to take the rounding out of your back. Go ahead and press yourselves up. Bring your knees together, please. Come onto your back. And keep your knees bent when you get to your back. And stack your right knee on top of your left knee. So the knees actually stack on top of each other. Good. Okay, we're going to come into supine gomukhasana. So you're just going to draw your knees into your chest and grab onto the outer feet with each hand. Grab, keep the palm up. See if this works better for you. Yeah, whichever you like. And then if you want, you can just navigate how much stretch do I want. You can take the heels in closer to your hips. You can take the heels further away. But whatever you do, allow the pose to open for you as opposed to forcing yourself into the pose. So just be mindful if you get aggressive with yourself. There's absolutely no need for that. You can get a great stretch by doing it gently. And if you catch yourself getting aggressive and then you hear a cue that says not to do that, then just forgive yourself for being aggressive. If you find yourself distracted, your mind running, and your breath becoming shallow, and then you become aware of it, then be thankful that you became aware as opposed to beating yourself up because you weren't for a span. Just keep it positive. And then from here, just keep your legs like this, but release your hands and set your left foot on the floor. Good. Now from here, keep the knees just like this. Just pick up your hips, take them 2 inches to the right, drop your knees to the left. Come back to center, please. Good. Unravel your legs. Level your hips. Left knee on top of the right knee. And take that gomukhasana from your back. And grab your feet like handles. Root your sacrum bone down. So the lower back stays down on the ground, the sacrum. Soften the shoulders, soften the elbows a little bit. And allow your breath to be thorough. And with no agenda to release anything, actually, with no agenda whatsoever, allow it to release and see what happens. Go ahead and release your hands and set your right foot down on the floor, the knees still stacked. Take your hips 2 inches to the left and drop your knees to the right. Come back to center. Hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a squeeze. And rock and roll yourself up to sit. It may not seem like a good idea, but once you get up, you'll be fine. Go ahead and close your eyes. Bring your palms together in front of your heart. And take a moment to forgive other people for the things that they've done to you. And forgive yourself for the things that you've done to other people. And forgive yourself for the things that you've done to yourself. We're all just doing the best we can. If you have time to rest in Shavasana, I suggest it. Otherwise, simply lift your heart, bow your head. Namaste.